This episode of DNews is brought to you by Subaru. I'm pretty tall, 6'2 or so, but there are people who are smaller, Amy, for instance, but there are also people who are huger in comparison to me. Just how big can we get? Howdy, shorties and tallies. Trace here for DNews, thank you for watching. Height is a big deal. It affects every aspect of a person's life, from their own perception of the world to how they are perceived by others. It's a pretty common misconception that people were shorter back in the day, but it's simply not true. 1,000 years ago, people were as tall as we are today, but during the 17th and 18th centuries, nutritional deficits during youth caused humans to shrink 2.5 inches on average. Dietary hardship, climate, and disease throughout history all affect height. People were not shorter in the past just because it was the past. They actually had the potential to be as tall as we are now, though humans do seem to have some kind of unofficial upper limit. The tallest person in history was Robert Wadlow. He stood 8 feet, 11.1 inches tall, and was almost 200 kilos when he died at 22 in 1940. The man was massive. The current world's tallest man is Sultan Kusun from Turkey, and he has the same disorder that Wadlow had, a tumor on his pituitary that causes it to squirt human growth hormone into his body, increasing his height abnormally. The reason we don't just keep getting larger is we actually have to live in the world. Gravity is constantly pulling us down, requiring our bodies to create bones which counteract that force to hold us up. It's all about balance. We are reaching the upper limit for human height because more weight requires larger bones, which requires more bodily resources to maintain. As an animal grows, its support structure must grow with it, which means bones and muscles must thicken, which can only happen so much. Plus, 7 to 8% of your body weight is just blood. So if you weigh 200 kilos, like Wadlow did, you'd have 14 kilograms of blood. That blood would need to be pressurized and then pumped through your veins, which, as size increases, gets a lot more difficult for the heart. So it needs more muscle, and there's only so much room in the human body, you can't just keep expanding everything. Elephants and giraffes have highly pressurized circulatory systems just to keep their blood flowing because of their size. Whales can grow larger than us because they don't live on land. The buoyancy of the water around them helps support their weight while their bones give structure to their body. Air buoyancy is extremely low out here. Only about 0.12% of your weight at sea level is buoyant in the air, where the air is thickest. If our air was thicker, it would help hold us up, allowing us to grow larger, but it would have to be a lot thicker, which could affect our ability to breathe it at all. In space, astronauts do gain a little height, growing as much as 3% taller because of the fluid in between the vertebrae of their spine relaxes and expands when not under the load of gravity. For someone like me, that could mean adding another 2 or more inches. On Mars, where gravity is only 38% of Earth, you would also get taller. But like if children were sent to Mars, they would get big. But Earth gravity would be a struggle of real proportions, so they'd kind of be stuck on that planet. If we lived underwater, we might be able to grow larger due to buoyancy, but there's a lot of pressure down there too. We couldn't walk on land at all either if we grow that way because our bones would break due to the lack of support. This is also why insects are limited in size. Exoskeletons can only grow so large before they are too heavy to support themselves. If you could be a giant safely, would you want to be? What's your ideal height? Let us know down in the comments and make sure you subscribe for more DNews. You can also download the Test Tube app so you can get all of our videos on the go. Then you can get a push notification whenever we upload a new video so you never miss a DNews. Sounds awesome, right? Go download it. Thanks for watching, everybody. This episode of DNews is brought to you by Subaru.